What is going on, guys? Prestige here, bringing up episode number 34 of The Road to Gold. This time, I am using the RPG-7, and the RPG-7 was actually a fan-requested weapon. So, guys, if you want to see your secondary weapon of choice, please feel free to leave a comment down below. I'll let you know in the comment section myself if I choose that weapon, and we'll go on from there. But this gameplay actually turned from wanting to try to get a lot of kills with the RPG-7 to actually playing the objective. At this point, I didn't know if I wanted to kind of go and get knife kills without missiles, or if I wanted to just stay on the objective and wait for people to kill me, if I wanted to kill myself to get more rounds for this thing. I just didn't know what I wanted to do, so I ended up trying to go all ninja sneaky mode, and it worked out to my advantage. So I hope you guys enjoy the gameplay, but let's talk about the RPG-7 for a second, because I actually went all theater mode magic on this gameplay for some reason. But the RPG-7 is not recommended for air support. It is not recommended to be used against enemies, and it is not recommended for any game type because it is that terrible. The blast radius of this is actually less than of a C4. It's terrible. I don't recommend using it at all. I know a lot of people are probably thinking, like, why didn't you try to do this in a free-for-all or something and try to get a free-for-all victory? Well, to be honest, I didn't want to do it in a free-for-all. I knew that I wasn't going to win a free-for-all, so why try it and why, you know, take the losses? And plus, there's a lot of spawn killing in that. It's just annoying as shit. So, Drop Zone is a game that I could play, and right here I want to point out, I am double-lying. Double-lying is also known as playing dead, and if you're using Assassin Pro, you can actually hide from the enemy because they'll think you're a dead body. But I didn't realize I wasn't using Assassin Pro. I was actually using Blast Shield Pro, because that's what a lot of people do in Drop Zone. I don't know why these people didn't kill me. They actually ran right past me, but I went into free cam mode, so you can all just kind of see what was going on. My outside point of view and my front point of view is just kind of boring, so I did that. The RPG is just terrible. I don't recommend using it. I think that you'd be much better off using other secondary weapons. Even the XM25 is a lot better. You have a better blast radius with the XM25, it seems. And at this point right here, I actually show you how terrible it is. I get a hit marker and I hit him pretty much point blank right there. So that is pretty much it for this episode. I go ninja the rest of the round, get our team the win, the victory, come in first place. I get 2 kills and 2 deaths. I know it was kind of a short one, but I still hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay. Keep in mind, if you want to leave a secondary weapon of choice down in the comments section, and please feel free to do that. I will check them out, let you know if I pick that secondary weapon. I only have one more primary weapon to do out of all of Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, and that is the USAS-12. Slowly working my way there, and it's taken me a long time because if you do all the challenges for the weapon, then it doesn't leave you with many challenges to earn XP for and get that towards your golden weapon. That's why it's taken so long. I apologize for that, guys. It will be out very soon, and that will be the completed list of Road to Golds for Modern Warfare 3. So, guys, if you like this video, please drop a like. If not, that is cool. Keep in mind, I am on the road to 20,000 subscribers. If you want to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. But until next time, I am out. Peace.